So we are here with Splunk. We have Sanjay Mehta from Splunk. Here's over a little bit. And they just announced Hadoop integration last week. And so we're really here to learn more about how you guys are integrating technology with Hadoop. And also wanted to hear a little bit about your angle on big data, because it's something that you've been involved in for a while.
Yes, this one was formed in 2004. And the problem we really set out to solve was collect and harness all of the machine data that gets generated by systems that power businesses. And what I mean by that are the application servers, network devices, security devices, all those things, all those components that sit within an IT infrastructure, or even outside of an IT infrastructure, generate data all the time. Now, the question really was what to do with that data, because it holds it has intrinsic value. It holds a record of all activity and behavior, whether it's your customer's behavior, whether it's user transactions, whether it's the actual behavior of the machines, the applications, the networks, things like that. And so we've been dealing with this challenge around how do you effectively collect and harness all of this high volume, unstructured or badly structured data, which is generated in, you know, it's, you know, when we talk to our customers, one thing we hear all the time is that machine data is the fastest growing, most complicated, yet most valuable segment of big data. And so what we really set out to do with our, you know, when our first product shipped in 2006 was to really provide the ability to harness the data. And the way we do that is we collect it from any source. We index the data, and what indexing does is it actually makes that data browsable, usable. You can run, you can interact with the data, and we provide a search language and visualization layer where you can actually run searches against the data. You can look at patterns or patterns of activity in real time, and you can also visualize it all in real time as well. So you can create dashboards, you can generate reports, you can send those reports as PDFs to your managers or bosses or whoever's interested in the data. So that's the thing we've been solving. And then what we've been hearing as well, we've got 3,000 plus customers, licensed customers. We have many more customers who download the free product. We have a free download model, so you can actually use the product for free. And what we found is customers that use our technology with Hadoop are asking for specific things. They're saying, can we use Splunk to collect all the data and then run analytics on it in real time as it's coming in? And even historical data as well. But then at some point, I want to transfer that data into HDFS for archival or for specialized algorithms that you can run as Hadoop jobs. The other thing they're asking for is they're saying, well, as I express a search, I want to be able to call Hadoop jobs and get the data from that back into my Splunk search and then present the results together. And then once it's in Splunk, you can visualize it, you can basically look at the data different ways. And the other thing is, I'm going to take the output of Hadoop jobs. So Hadoop jobs themselves are generating output files and do something with that data. And so you can index it by Splunk and have Splunk to index that data. Once it's in Splunk, you can, again, very quickly search and visualize it. So.
Yeah, and when you talk about machine data and its growing importance, and really look at some of the areas in which, at least the industries that are looking to really put this technology to work, you're seeing a lot of real-world use cases in the social sphere. Even here at the sessions, there's a couple of social sites, Facebook, a couple others that are really, you know, actually putting this to work. Some of their features are already live on the site. So when it comes to really pulling that value, they seem like they're ready, willing, and able to kind of jump on that. And when it comes to your business model, bringing something like Hadoop into something that can be a monetizable aspect of your growing business.
Yeah, I think from our perspective, where we see, where do customers see the value? And I think that's a really good question to ask, because once you've got all this data, how do you use it, right? And there's lots of examples, or there's a few examples of which really are the examples that led to the technology being built in the first place, from the Googles and Yahoos of this world. I think our what we're focused on is how do you democratize the data and get it out into mainstream use cases. And the mainstream use cases we found for Splunk are around, historically, are more around the IT side. So it's helping manage applications, it's helping enforce security or provide a better security posture meet compliance mandates, manage and monitor your infrastructure. And then increasingly, we've started to see uses, because the same data, as I mentioned earlier on, holds all of that categorical information around who's doing what are the machines doing, but what are the people that are interacting with those machines doing too. So the other thing as well that we're seeing is that people are starting to use it for increased intelligence and analytics from their operational data. They're saying, how's my website being used? How are streaming assets that are going through my website, how are they being used? Because I need to know that to be able to reconcile my royalty payments. How are my call records going from a telecoms perspective? Because to us, it's all just data. And whether it's a Twitter stream that's human-generated in terms of the tweets themselves, or whether it's log files from machines or applications, all of that to us is just data. And and we don't impose any type of schema ahead of time, so we can take that data in real time and then allow you to just look at it and ask questions that you may not have thought of yet. Well, you may have thought of just now and get an answer to that question. And that's really what we're focused on. And so with Hadoop, what that gives us is the ability to use the benefits of Spark, but also then have Hadoop available for specialized algorithms and processing. But also, if there is data in Hadoop that isn't in Splunk, and we want to be able to bring that into Splunk, then you can actually use that data as well. So we see it very complementary.
I agree. Well, it's certainly great to hear what you guys are doing with big data and how you're leveraging Hadoop's technology. And thank you for coming on to theCUBE.
Thank you.